What are top-up health insurance policies? And then Avijit Karmakar, thanks Avijit for your question, is writing in, what is the difference between super top-up and top-up policy? And is it cashless?
I'll explain the difference between a top-up and a super
top-up. Top-up, super top-up, please. It sounds a little complicated.
So in insurance, there is something called agri. Okay, first let me explain what is a top-up or a top-up per se. So top-up is that, let's say you have a 3 lakh cover. Or even if you don't have a 3 lakh cover, you say that from 0 to 3 lakhs, I will cover from my own pocket. In case my expenses, my hospitalization expenses cross 3 lakhs, then I need a health insurance cover, right? So that 0 to 3 is something called a deductible, right? And you say that I will top up above 3 lakhs, right? So that's a top up slash a super top up. Or that's the, you know, fundamental definition of a deductible. Deductible is that for this amount, either I will take care from my own pocket or somebody, some other company, whether it's my, you know, my other health insurance plan or whether it's my employer provided health insurance plan, they will cover, right? So that's the deductible above which the top up slash the super top up covers, right? Now, the difference between the broad difference between a top up and a super top up is that a top up works on a catastrophic basis. So when I say catastrophic basis means, so let's say you've taken a deductible of 3 lakhs. For a top up to trigger, each claim has to be above 3 lakhs.
Okay.
Right? For a super top up trigger, in 1 year, the aggregate amount, if it crosses 3 lakhs, super top up will trigger. So okay. The difference between a top up and a super top up is catastrophic, which means every claim has to cross the deductible amount. In a super top up, the aggregate claims in the year have to cross the deductible amount. So that's the difference between, broad difference between a top up.
So should one be taking that?
One should now opt for a super top up, which works on an aggregate basis, than a top up. Because top up works on one
super
time.
Super top up, Avijit, works better than a top up. You can consider, is it cashless?
So cashless will depend on the, so what is cashless slash reimbursement, right? So every insurance company says that I will start enrolling hospitals with whom I have a tie up and I can offer cashless. So when I say cashless means, so let's say there are 10 hospitals out there. I have an agreement with 5 of them. And the other 5 I'm working on. So if you go to any 5 of them, you don't have to shell anything from your pocket, which means it's cashless. Okay. It does not mean that you can't go to the other 5. Hmm. You can go to the other 5, but since I don't have a tie-up with them.
Then it becomes reimbursed.
So you
it's
go
more
there,
a insurance company hospital tie-up issue
rather than
anything
else. Rather than anything.
Okay. In fact, Avijit said, thanks for addressing my query. And he has another question. I think he's listening to you very carefully. You were talking about your parents. He says, he has parents who are 70 years of age. How can I deal with health insurance, or is it just better to store some cash for them?
Health insurance is always important.
And at 70, can he get for them?
Depends on the medical conditions. They should opt for it. In fact, this is a discussion which I was having with the CEO of an insurance company. Mm. And he said, the reason I don't have is because I invest.
Yeah.
I invest in
mutual
funds.
One of the other person asked this question.
Yes.
I'm glad that you brought that up, because his question was that, why don't I just do an SIP and build my investment and that becomes my insurance?
Exactly. So I pay a premium for my parents. I premium of about 75,000 every year for a 25 lakh cover.
Hmm.
Right? The reason I pay so much is I am not looking at only one claim. I am looking at multiple claims that may happen, right?
Few years
so
as
what,
I get older.
So what if it's a recurring expense?
Yeah.
Then what happens?
Yeah.
See, it is not a one-time claim,
correct,
right? So you may say, 75,000 I am paying for 10 years at 7.5. If I do an SIP, this is what I will, you know, this is, I will get, let's say 15 lakhs or 16 lakhs, right? That'll take care of one claim. But what if the claims are recurrent? Then what happens, right? So hence, health insurance is critical.